Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about upper and lower bounds. So, previously on Hegarty Maths we've learnt how to round to the nearest hundred. Pause the video and try these examples, it's very important you do that. Round the following to the nearest 100. Okay, you should have got the following answers. The first one rounded to 700, the next one 700, the next one 700, the next one 700, and the last one, because it was a 5, it rounds up to 800. I'm going to come back to ask you to spot a pattern with that later. Right, have a go at another set. Round the following to the nearest whole number. Pause and have a go. And here are the answers. The first one rounded to 7, so did the second, so did the third, so did the fourth, and the fifth actually rounded to 8 because it was 7.5. Okay. Look at all these numbers that rounded to 700. They start at 650 and they end at 749.9 recurring. Any number between those two round to 700. But if you're just a tiny bit more than 749.9 recurring, i.e. 750, you round up to 800. And have a look at this. Any number from 6.5 all the way up to 7.49 recurring rounds to 7. But if you're just slightly more than that, okay, you round up to 8. If you're at 7.5, you round to 8. So, if I asked you the following questions, think of the set of numbers that round to the nearest 100 as 700, and think of the set of all the numbers that round to the nearest 1 as 7, how could you write it? Well, we just said it was any set of numbers from 650 all the way up to just a little bit short of 750, because we know 750 actually rounds upwards, so that doesn't include, but we said up to 749.9 recurring, didn't we? Okay, so any number between there and there rounds to 700, right? And this number here is called your lower bound, and this number here is called your upper bound. So your lower bound is the smallest number that rounds to 700, and the upper bound is the biggest possible number that rounds to 700, to the nearest 100. Now, I've told you before that mathematicians are super lazy, right? And they tend to, they call the lower bound 650, but because they can't be bothered to write 649.9 recurring, they actually write 750, because they're just lazy. Now, I know 750 should round up, but they just write 750. But when they write it, they mean a number just a tiny, tiny bit smaller than 750, i.e. 749.9 recurring. The true and best mathematical way of writing it is to show it as an interval. And I've showed you this in a previous video. We do a square bracket to say we want to include 650. And we want all the numbers up to, so we have a comma there, 750, but to show we don't want to include 750, we have a curly bracket like that. And that means this picture. That means any number from 650 exactly up to 749.9 recurring. Again, this is called the lower bound, 750 is called the upper bound. What about, could you do the same thing with 7? Could you write it in this proper mathematical way? All the set of numbers that round to 7 to the nearest 1. Well, 6.5 is the smallest possible number that rounds up to 7, and the biggest possible number is 7.49999, but we write that as 7.5, but we put a curly bracket round that side. 6.5 is known as the lower bound, 7.5 is known as the upper bound, and that's what upper and lower bounds are. Way to find the upper and lower bound. If someone has told you a number has been rounded to the nearest 1, okay, that's the digit 1. You know if you half that number, so you half that number is 0.5, so you do 1 divided by 2, you get 0.5. If you subtract that from 7, and you get 6.5. If you add it to 7, you get 7.5. Your upper and lower bounds super easily. Let's try it up here. Someone told you that this was rounded to the nearest 100. You half 100, and you get 50. You do 700 take away 50 to get the lower bound. You do 700 add 50 to get the upper bound. A really quick way of getting them. So let's use that technique to answer the following. What are the set of numbers that would round to the nearest thousand as this? Well, 1,000 is what we're rounding to. We're going to half that, and that's going to be 500. We're going to subtract it with the square brackets to get the lower bound. We're going to add it on to 5,000 to get 5,500 with the curly brackets to get the upper bound. Let's do the same thing here. Half of 100 is 50. We're going to subtract it to get 5,350 for the lower bound. We're going to add it to get 5,450 with curly brackets to get the upper bound. The nearest 10 here is what we've rounded to. We're going to half that and get 5. So the lower bound is 5,465 and the upper bound is 5,475 with curly brackets. To the nearest 1 here, we're going to half that and get 0.5, subtract and add it. So we're going to get 5,477.5 for the lower bound and 5,478.5 with curly brackets for the upper bound. And the nearest 10th here, we're going to half a 10th, so is 0.05, that's half of 0.1 or 0.10. So we're going to subtract that and add that on to get the upper and lower bound. So 5,5 subtracted and 5,478.65 for the upper bound added on. And lastly, the nearest 100th. 100th is 0.01. Half that is 0.005. So we're going to subtract that to get 5,478.625 for the lower bound and 5,478.635 for the upper bound with curly brackets. With these type of questions, we're asked to state the upper and lower bound of each of the following given they've been rounded as in the bracket. So here this number's been rounded to the nearest 10. We half that and get 5. Subtract it to get the lower bound, add it to get the upper bound. So the lower bound is going to be 1,735. The upper bound is going to be 1,745 with curly brackets. This has been rounded to the nearest 1. We half it to get 0.5. We subtract it to get 52.5 for the lower bound and we get 53.5 for the upper bound. And lastly, this has been a measure to the nearest 1,000, so we half that to get 500, and so we subtract it to get 24,500 for the lower bound and 25,500 for the upper bound. Right, next. Again, find the upper and lower bound given that the following rounding has happened. 630 to 2SF. Now, the second significant figure is in the tens column. So we know we've rounded to the nearest 10, so we half 10 and get 5. Subtract it and add it to get the upper and lower bound. That will give us 625 and 635 with a comma. One significant figure here. The first significant figure is in the tens column. So we've rounded to nearest 10, we half it to get 5, subtract it to get the lower bound, add it on to get the upper bound. 1SF here. The first significant figure is the thousands column. So we've rounded to the nearest 1,000. We half that to get 500, subtract it to get the lower bound, 4,500, add it to get the upper bound, 5,500 with brackets. And lastly, this has been rounded to 2SF. The second significant figure is the nearest 1. We half 1 to get a half, and we subtract to get 52.5 for the lower bound and 53.5 for the upper bound. Again, state the upper and lower bound given the rounding in the brackets. This has been rounded to 1dp, which is to the nearest 0.1. We half that and get 0.05. Subtract it from this for the lower bound, add it to get the upper. So that'd be 78.25 for the lower, 78.35 for the upper. This has been rounded to 2dps, which is the nearest 100th. We half that to get the following. We subtract it and add it on to get the upper and lower bound. So we get 138.555 and we would get 138.565 for the upper bound. Lastly, this has been rounded to 3dp, the nearest 1,000th. So a 1,000th's like that. To half that, you get 0.0005. Subtract it for the lower bound, add it for the upper. 99,538.5685 for the lower bound and 99,538.565 0.5695 for the upper bound. And that's it for an introduction to upper and lower bounds.